Remember first grade, when you were finally in grade school? And even though little Timmy might still be eating his boogers, at least he's not doing it in kindergarten. You get to class and the teacher walks you through what you're gonna learn that year. She tells you that you're gonna have a party for the 100th day of class. Back then, 100 days seemed so far away. But the weeks passed, and not too long after, you were celebrating with your classmates. Eating 100 goldfish, seeing who could run 100 feet the fastest. It was a good time. Well, several years ago, I read something that changed the way I approached the end of the year. The gist of it was that today, there's only 100 days left in the year. To put it in perspective, just over 14 weeks, about a semester. So if there's anything that you'd hope to accomplish this year, you should chase after it with the time you have left. I find this approach of using a countdown to an end date to be much more freeing than a start date when it comes to goal setting, like you see with New Year's resolutions. Looking at it this way, you know that the time is finite, and those 100 days are going to pass whether or not you chase after the goal you set for yourself. I also find that 100 days is the perfect length of time for setting a medium-term goal. It isn't exactly an indicator of where you'll be in 5 years, but it's long enough that you can see progress. If your goal is fitness-related, you'll see the physical changes in your body and the way that you feel. If your goal is to learn a language, you might not be fluent, but you should know some vocabulary and grammatical structures so that you can hold a simple conversation. The point being, it's a substantial enough amount of time to achieve a complex goal. It's an easy block of time that you can break down long-term goals into, and then evaluate your progress at the end. See where you're at. How do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. But if you consider every day to be a bite, then 100 days should be an elephant meal. Even if you don't hit your goal, you'll be that much closer to it than if you waited until New Year's to start chasing after it. Last year, in March of 2020, when everything kicked off, 2 weeks to flatten the curve, everyone set some type of goal to better themselves during the pandemic. People were going to read a book a week, learn Italian so they could finally visit once we could travel again, start jogging so that they can keep up with their kids. But how many people do you know actually did that? Now, how many people do you know that ate like garbage and drank far too much? I hope this doesn't come off as judgy or preachy, because 2020 was a gas leak year for pretty much everybody.
Oh, there was that gas leak last year.
Oh, don't blame it all on a gas leak year.
And 2021 hasn't been a whole lot better. And if it wasn't bad for you, then great, I'm very happy for you. But I don't want people to hear this and then get it in their head that they need to feel guilty for coasting through the pandemic. In cultures rooted in the Judeo-Christian tradition, there's a large emphasis put on guilt and shame. But life is short, and then you die. So learn from your mistakes, but don't become defined by them. In that same vein of learning to forgive your past self, do something that will help out the future version of you. The life is short mantra can push you towards hedonism, and while you should enjoy things in life, you also need to find a balance that works for you and the person you want to be. But I digress. Anyways, today, September 22nd, marks the 100th day until the end of 2021. So set your goals and go achieve them. I look forward to hearing what everyone's done by New Year's.